Humanists of the Islamic civilization, all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of all worlds, who says in his ever glorious book, "People, be mindful of your Lord who created you from a single soul. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is his servant and messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him, his household, companions, and upon those who follow their path to the Day of Judgment." Islam has established a civilization that aimed at perfecting human values to the highest degree and drawing the path of affection, fraternity, justice, and equality for humanity through building a moral and civilized system that aspires for unity and construction, not division and destruction, in order to bring about security, peace, goodness for all people. The Islamic civilization has derived its human values from the glorious Quran and the Prophet Sunnah. The Almighty Allah said, "People, we created all of you from a single man and a single woman, and made you into races and tribes so that you should recognize one another. In Allah's eyes, the most honored of you are the ones most mindful of Him. Allah is all-knowing, all-aware. Thus, humans are dignified creatures through the dignity bestowed upon them by the Almighty Allah, regardless of their color, race, or faith. As Allah, glory be to Him, said, 'We have honored the children of Adam.' Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, also said, 'All of the people are the children of Adam, and Adam was created from dust.'" It was narrated that once a funeral based by the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, he stood up. He was told that it's a funeral of a Jew. He replied, "It is not a soul." Among the manifestation of the humanness in the Islamic civilization is recognition of the principle of freedom of belief clearly in a way that does not accept misinterpretation, which implies the freedom of worship, protection of places of worship for all people, and its reduction of all forms of coercion and tourism. As the Almighty Allah says, "There shall be no coercion in religion." As the Almighty Allah says, "There shall be no coercion in religion." Allah also said, "Had your Lord willed, all the people on the earth would have believed. So can you, Prophet, compile people to believe?" Allah the Most High also said, "So Prophet, warn them. Your only task is give warning." Prophet, warn them. Your only task is give warning. You are not there to control them. And said, "Your only duty is to deliver the message." Other important aspects of humanism in Islamic civilization include calling for mercy with the weak, respecting the elderly, and giving the people with a special need their full rights. Our Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Allah support this ummah because the weak amongst it, through their supplication, prayers, and their sincerity." He, peace be upon him, also said, "He is not one of us who show no mercy to younger one and does not acknowledge the honor due to our elders." Once Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu passed by an old man of the Prophet of the people of the book. And that old man was begging. Umar commented, "This is not justice that we enjoy the fruit of their labor when they are young and be neglectful when they are old. Then he ordered that Baytul Mal gives him and the likes of him sufficient expenditures. The Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, the merciful are shown mercy by Allah. The merciful are shown mercy by Allah, the most compassionate. Be merciful on the earth. Be merciful in the earth, and you will be shown mercy from the one who is above the heaven. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the whole world. May Allah peace and blessing be upon Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, his companions and followers. The humanness of Islamic civilization was not restricted to dealing with human being, but it extended to include merciful dealing with animals. A perfect example for that is once the Prophet, peace be upon him, entered the garden of a man from Al-Ansar, helper. All of a sudden, when a camel saw the Prophet, peace be upon him, it wept tenderly, producing yearning sound, and its eyes flawed. The Prophet, peace be upon him, came to it and wiped the temple of its head. So it kept calm. He then said, who is the owner of this camel? Whose camel is this? A young man from Al-Ansar came and said, this is mine, Prophet of Allah. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, don't you fear Allah about this beast which Allah has given in your possession? It has complained to me that you keep it hungry and load it heavily, which fatigues, which cannot stand it. Also, once the Prophet, peace be upon him, saw a bird with her two young ones, and the young one were captured. The bird came and began to spread its wing. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, came and said, who grieved this for its young ones? Return its young ones to it. How much the humanity needs to achieve these principles and values that have characteristics that have characterized our civilization throughout history. O Allah, we ask you to make our country Egypt and prosper all other countries. Thank you so much.